Now, in the previous video, we have explained how to generate a path from a term reference field. In this video, we'll explain how to create a better path for a taxonomy term to cater for a multi-level taxonomy. Let's first go to pattern page. Let's go to configuration, search and metadata, URL aliases, patterns. Scroll down. This is our taxonomy term path. We use only vocab and term name to form the pattern. Let's go to taxonomy we created earlier. Go to structure, taxonomy, category, right click on the mouse and open in the new tab. Let's click on this. Click on fashion. Well, the path is just nice. Category slash fashion. Let's go back. What about shoes this time? Now shoes is the third level. You can see that it doesn't join its parent terms, which are fashion and man, into the path. So let's improve the pattern a bit for the taxonomy term path. Back to our pattern page now. Let's add one more token in between the vocab and terms name. Type slash. Place our cursor in between the two slashes. So we're going to fill a token in between here. Let's click on replacement patterns, taxonomy terms, go down, parents, join path, and click on this token link. Yes, it has already filled it up. Great, that's it. So let's scroll down and save the configuration. Back to the term page, let's update the path, edit, scroll down, and check generate automatic URL alias. Click save. Now let's view. That's great. A full path has now been generated. We have category, slash fashion, slash man, slash shoes. So fashion and man are the parents of shoes term. Now let's go back to our taxonomy page again. Structure, taxonomy, category. Let's try women this time. As you can see, this is the old path that has not yet been updated. So click edit, scroll down, check this, and click save. View. Great, parent has been joined to the path. Now, possibly you have noticed something by now. That's every time when you update the pattern for a particular entity, like content type, taxonomy, or even user, the checkbox generate automatic URL areas will be unchecked. Now, the checkbox I meant is this structure, taxonomy, category. Let's click on clothing. Edit, go down. This is the checkbox I'm saying. Every time when you update the pattern for this taxonomy, this checkbox will be unchecked automatically. This means the old path are not affected by your new pattern unless you update them manually. Now, if you want all the paths to be updated at one time, then you can do a bulk update instead of doing it one by one as I did just now. So let's go to the pattern page again. Let's go back here. Click on Delete Aliases tab. Check taxonomy terms. And delete aliases now. Go back to bulk update. Check taxonomy term paths and update. Let's click on List. We sort by system. One more time. Now, as you can see, all your taxonomy term paths have been regenerated follow the new pattern. Now, a final note to you, you have to be careful when changing the pattern path on the live site. Google might already have indexed your links and paths. So if you update all the old paths, you may have to use some redirection modules to ensure all your old paths be redirected to the new one correctly. Else people will be led to the unfound page, Okay, hope you have learned something useful from our tutorials. Remember to subscribe to our channel for more interesting sharings to come. Stay tuned.